This is the F150 Lightning from Ford. It's a fully electric pickup truck. Very big car, measures almost 6 meters and weighs in at 2.9 tons. It has the extended range. That means that it has a bigger battery with a net capacity of 131 kilowatt hours and a gross capacity of over 140 kilowatt hours. That's a big battery, NMC battery. The EPA range, because there is no VLTP range available yet, is 515 kilometers. So we can expect a VLTP range of over 540 kilometers. I'm just guessing, but I think that's around that ballpark. So this episode is about testing the range, consumption, acceleration, and noise of the F-150 Lightning Extended Range Lariat Trim. This car is brought to me by Exclusive Cars. Exclusive Cars is currently one of the few importers of the F-150 in Sweden. So it's adapted to the Swedish market with all the lighting in front, at the back, power connectors, charge port. It's using a CCS port. Adapted for the Swedish market in a really professional way. It's driving on 20-inch wheels, 275, 60 R20. So big tires, wide tires, SUV tires with a lot of rubber. So let's start with range and consumption. I'm gonna do it on my regular track of 80 kilometers with an average speed of 93 kilometers per hour. So speeds between 50 and 110 kilometers. Dry roads, 25 degrees outside, not that much of a wind. So really good conditions for scoring a good range. Can it be possible to beat the EPA range today in this perfect conditions? I think we have a possibility for that. So let's jump in and try. I have just started the range and consumption test. This is a 80 kilometers long test cycle that I'm always running for all my cars. It's a mix between 50 all the way up to 110 kilometers per hour. So the average speed is 93 kilometers per hour. That's a fairly normal average speed in Europe, at least in Scandinavia, maybe not on German autobahns, but it will give you a good indication. The F-150 doesn't have any eco mode, so I'm driving on normal. AC is set to 20 degrees Celsius. It's by default turning off the passenger side of the AC, so only cooling the driver's side. That's good, that will save some energy at least. But keep in mind, this is a truck. It's almost 6 meters long and weighs in at 2.9 tons in curb weight. And as you saw in the introduction, it has a very big, flat and high front and bonnet that will also catch some air resistance. So the CV value of all pickups available is of course higher than normal passenger cars. But to compensate for that, Ford has actually put in a big battery into this car. So this is the 110 kilometer stretch, the quickest stretch. So let's look at the energy consumption. We have traveled for almost 17 kilometers. The average consumption is 25 kilowatt hours per 100 kilometer. If we can keep to this consumption, we will actually beat the EPA range. Let's see. I mean, it's 24 degrees outside, totally dry roads, good conditions. Trying to hurry because it is going to start raining soon, so I hope I will be able to finish the test cycle before the rain starts, because as you know, rain and wet roads adds to the consumption. Just hit the halfway, 40 kilometers, average consumption 23 kilowatt hours per 100 kilometer, so that's below the stated EPA consumption. That sounds really good, so let's hope that it will carry on all the way. 22, just dropped. That's a good consumption for such a big car. I got hit by a very small amount of rain. for like 2 kilometers, but still dry roads. On this specific spot, it hasn't rained yet, so this is good. Hopefully I will be able to finish the whole test without ruining the consumption test with too much rain and wet roads. But it looks good. This screen actually summarizes the whole consumption. So as you see here, 41.2 kilometers traveled. Climate use 1%, 94% has been used for driving, 2% for accessories, that's probably safety systems, etc. 3% for exit temperature. I don't know if that's about warming the battery or something else, not sure. But as you see, a good overview. And in general, I think it's a good system. So very soon to complete the consumption range test, 26 or 25 kilowatt hours per 100 kilometer. That's a good consumption for this car. And by the way, have you ever seen anyone using the rear wipers like that? Is it waving to me? Are they trying to say something? It looks very funny. I mean, if it starts raining, that won't help that much, I think. But it looks funny. So that was the range and consumption test. It scored a really good result, but first, let's open an alcohol-free cider, just because I can. There's two openers, one at this side, one at the other one. So, what actually happened? The final consumption was 23.8 kilowatt hours per 100 kilometer. That's after a slight deduction, because the car actually underreports the distance by almost 1%. So that consumption translates into a total range of 550 kilometers. I mean, that's better than the stated EPA range of 515 kilometers. I think that's possibly on par with my estimated VLTP range. So 550 kilometers in perfect conditions. So I mean, expect lower range in rain, snow, cold temperatures, etc., or higher speeds. I mean, it's a very big car. So in high speeds, above 110 kilometers per hour, it will consume a lot more energy. Because I mean, you have seen the front of the car. It's like a house. So the CV value is high, the air resistance is high, and that will of course affect the consumption negatively the faster you go. So let's move on. It's time to test the acceleration. I'm gonna show you what this car actually can do. 97% state of charge. It's time for the first 0 to 100 kilometers test, or 0 to 60 miles per hour test. Let's go.
Zero to 60 miles per hour time 4.34 seconds. Zero to 100 km time 4.58 seconds.
Did a little bit of a wheel spin in the first attempt. Maybe tires are a bit too cold. It's 25 degrees outside. Let's try that again. It's time for a second attempt. State of charge still 97%. Let's see if we can get a better grip. Let's see if we can get a better grip this time. Go. Sports mode active. Oh, this is quick.
0 to 60 miles per hour time 4.21 seconds. 0 to 100 km time 4.43 seconds.
So let's do another try. State of charge 96%. Sports mode active. Go.
0 to 60 miles per hour time 4.46 seconds. 0 to 100 km time 4.69 seconds.
So it still gives me a bit of a wheel spin. This time the front wheels or the front tires actually didn't grip good enough to keep the torque to the ground. So maybe it's due to the tires. I will do a last attempt. 96% state of charge, sports mode active, dry road, 24 degrees Celsius, so good conditions. The tires is probably heated enough now. Let's go. Still wheel spin.
0 to 60 miles per hour time 4.21 seconds. 0 to 100 km time 4.44 seconds.
So as you saw, I managed to do 0 to 100 kilometers in 4.4 seconds and 0 to 60 miles per hour in 4.2 seconds. I haven't seen any official figures for 0 to 100 kilometers per hour, but I guess it's around 4.2 seconds. So very close. The 0 to 60 time, the official 0 to 60 time is 4 seconds flat. So it's 0.2 seconds away from hitting or achieving the specified time. That's really good. I mean, it's good conditions, dry roads, etc. But as you saw in the clip, it gives me a bit of a wheel spin, especially on the front tires. So I guess with bigger rims and better or sportier tires with a bit more grip, it will probably be able to achieve the specified time. So let's move on. It's time for the noise test. I will not bore you with a long driving video measuring noise. So this is the results. You see it here in the table. I have never measured noise levels in a pickup truck before, so I don't have anything good in comparison to the F-150. But it's above my expectations. It feels and drives really good. It feels silent, it feels comfortable, and as I said, way above my expectations for this kind of a car. So impressive. So in total, I think this is a really attractive package. Finally, we have a fully electric pickup truck without any compromises. I mean, you have the range, you have the performance, you have the towing capacity, you have all the practical aspects of the car, like this one. So in total, an impressive car. I think Ford has done a great job for creating a fully electric pickup truck. One of the first on the market. So great performance, silent and comfortable to drive. Really good range for such a big car. A good package. That's it. Give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel. I'm releasing more content. It's on the way for the F-150. So stay tuned. And as always, stay electric. Thank you for watching. Speak to you soon.